Beloved brothers and sisters, because Andrew and Ryan, your relatives and friends, and my spiritual sons, are now to be advanced to the order of priests, consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church to which they are about to be raised. It is true that God has made his entire holy people a royal priesthood. Nevertheless, our great high priest, Jesus Christ, chose certain disciples to carry out publicly in his name and on behalf of the whole world a priestly office in the church. For Christ was sent by the Father, and he in turn sent the apostles into the world, so that through them and their successors, the bishops, he might continue to exercise his office of teacher, priest, and shepherd. Indeed, priests are established as co-workers of the order of bishops, with whom they are joined in the priestly office, with whom they are called to the service of the people of God. After mature deliberation, Andrew and Ryan are now to be ordained to the priesthood in the order of the presbyterate, so as to serve Jesus Christ, whose ministry, his body that is the church, is formed into a holy nation and a royal priesthood and God's own possession. Being configured to Christ, the eternal high priest, and joined to the priesthood of the bishops, they will be consecrated as true priests of the New Testament to preach the gospel, to shepherd God's people, and celebrate the sacred liturgy, especially the Lord's most holy sacrifice. Now, my dear sons, Andrew and Ryan, you are to be ordained to the order of the priesthood. For your part, you will exercise the sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ the teacher, impart to everyone the word of God which you have received with joy. Meditating on the law of the Lord, see that you believe what you read, that you teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. This way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people. Let the holiness of your lives be a delightful fragrance to Christ's faithful, so that by word and example you may build up God's holy church. You will also exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying, for by your ministry, the spiritual sacrifices of the faithful will be made perfect, being united to the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered through your hands in an unbloody manner at the altar in union with the sacred assembly in the celebration of the divine mysteries. Understand what you do. Imitate what you celebrate. As ministers of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, strive to put to death whatever is sinful in your life and walk always in the newness of life. Remember, when you gather others into the people of God through baptism, when you forgive sins in the name of Christ and his church in the sacrament of penance, when you comfort and heal the sick with holy oil, when you celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer prayers of praise, thanks, and intercession through the liturgy of the hours for the church and for the whole world, remember that you were taken from among the people and appointed on their behalf for all those things that pertain to God. Therefore, carry out the ministry. ministry of Christ the priest with constant joy, genuine love, attending not to your own concerns, but to those of the Lord and those you serve. Remember as well, my dear sons, exercising for your part the office of Christ the head and chief shepherd, while always united with the bishop and subject to him, work to bring the faithful together into one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father through his Son, Jesus Christ, and in the power of the Holy Spirit. Throughout the coming years of your priesthood, strive to imitate the missionary zeal of Père Marquette, the heroic witness of Gabriel de Raborde, the proto-martyr of Illinois, the generosity of John Marie Vianney, the patron saint of all parish priests, the determined energy of John Lancaster Spaulding, our founding bishop, the manifest holiness of the venerable servant of God, Fulton Sheen, and the great good example of the many priest heroes who came before you and labored so hard to build up the Holy Church of Peoria. As priests, consciously honor in your ministry the heavenly patrons of this diocese, the prayerfulness of St. Therese of Lisieux, the quiet strength of St. Joseph the Worker, and the incomparable sanctity of our Blessed Lady, St. Mary of the Immaculate Conception. Remember always, Christ is our High Priest forever, our temple, our sacrifice, the very incarnation of God's Word. If you wish to heal wounds, he is the doctor. If you wish to deliver from sin, he is our justification. If you long to flee from darkness, he is our light. If you hunger for food, he is nourishment. If you fear death, he is life everlasting. If you wish to see God face to face, Jesus Christ is the way. And in his great goodness, the Lord Jesus Christ accomplishes this wonderful work of salvation in the form of a servant. So you must always seek God's will, not your own. In holy orders, you will be ordained not for your personal convenience, but for generous ministry. Therefore, keep always before your eyes the example of Christ, the Good Shepherd, who came not to be served, but to serve, and to seek out and save all those who were lost.